The National Planning Authority report released last year indicates that the working age population grew from 16.5 million between 2012 and 2013 to 19.1 million in 2016-2017, with at least 700,000 persons entering the labor market every year. The report further shows that only about 38,000 persons are absorbed into the labor market, and this is expected to rise to about 1 million between 2030 and 2040, according to the World Bank. Laziness, absenteeism, and poor work ethics are some of the factors affecting the quality of labor in Uganda. Kadaga further implored Ugandans to adopt a positive work attitude as a means of improving the quality of work in the country.
We have violation of ethical principles of fairness, honesty, and integrity. There is a high level of theft of time and materials, as well as cost defraud customers in both public and private sectors. A lot of company time is also social media. A worker will come in the morning, start with Facebook, go to Twitter, go to Instagram. In the process, a person aged between 16 and 24 will probably spend five hours on social media.
The other hand, also government agencies and others complained about companies also practicing unethical behaviors in business practices. For example, so many of these firms are avoiding paying taxes. They are practicing false accounting. They are increasing and imposing huge workloads on employees, which is creating high stress and exploitation on the employees.
During the International Labour Conference held today in Kampala, a number of issues affecting labour productivity in the country were discussed. These include underemployment, poor remuneration of workers, worker compensation, and illegal dismissal from work, among others.
Employers have resorted to subcontracting and outsourcing services or hiring workers temporarily to avoid legal responsibilities, or, for example, compensating injured workers in case they get injured in their workplace. So they tell you, no, that's not my worker. That worker is for this other company. Use this to dodge contribution of employees to NSSF. Many employers in most of these industrial parks do not give employees written employment contract.
This project is crucial to support the ministry in promoting decent work and social protection. And it is composed of four pillars, maybe very briefly. One is decent work creation. And it's not about skilling, because skilling is not sufficient. You know, you can skill someone and then what? You know, it is about a lot of the things that we said today, going beyond skilling. Post-skilling, mindset change, decent work amongst employees.
Rachel Nashwala reporting for the news.